good morning and happy new year. Y'all don't look any older. Yeah. Did y'all have a good New Year's? Amen. Amen. I tell you, I don't know a better way to start this new year off than a good friend of mine, Jamie Coulter. He's going to come up here in a little bit. But let's stand. Sing His mercy and His grace, and oh, I think that's the wrong song. Where are you at? That's what we're supposed to be when the roll is called up yonder. I was wondering. I said, I don't look like it. Say what? That might be offertory. I don't know. I don't know what we're doing. I mean, when I was talking to Jamie earlier, he said, we just want to let the Lord do it His way. And I guess that's what the Lord wants, you know. There it is. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning makes eternal bright and fair, when the saints on earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. On that bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise and the glory of His resurrection share, when His chosen ones shall gather to the home beyond the sky and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. Let us labor for the Master from the dawn to setting sun. Let us talk of all His wondrous love and care. Then when all the life is over and the work is there be done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
You think you can?
Yeah.
I just have a few announcements. Let's go to the Lord in prayer first. Father, it's so good to be in Your house this morning. God, I just pray Your blessings upon us this morning. Father, please, please, may Your Spirit move among us in such a mighty way this morning, Father, that each one of our heartstrings will be struck in a special, special way, Father. Father, that we can leave here saying it's been good to be in the house. Thank You, Father, for Your Spirit and Your love this morning. For it's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Go and have a seat. Prayer meeting this week, we meet at Larry's Hall on Tuesday night at 5:30. Everyone's invited to be there. I'm not going to read all of these. Let y'all go through. I got a couple of special ones that I want to make note of. This morning you have this envelope in the bulletin. Brother Jamie, come on a love offering. Y'all give a love offering. We'll be taking that up at the end of service. So that's for this one. A Lottie Moon offering in gathering next week. We'll have an envelope for that next week. Okay? Wednesday evening, 4:30, we're going to gather in the sanctuary today to take down our Christmas. And so we'll take it down and put it up the next year to keep it in our home. All right. That's all, Stan. Okay, Paul. It's 6:30, I'm sorry. Stan, keep standing. Y'all shake hands. Tell somebody you love them.
Let's all remain standing. This is going to be our offertory hymn. Count your blessings. Name them one by one.
When upon my bills you are tempted, tossed, when you are discouraged, thinking all is lost, count your many blessings. Name them one by one. See what God has done. Count your blessings. Name them one by one. Count your many blessings. See what God has done. Are you heavy burdened with the load of care? Does it cross you heavy? You are called to bear. Count your many blessings. Every man will fly. One by one, count your blessings. See what God has done. Count your blessings. Name them one by one. Count your many blessings. See what God has done. When you look at others with your lands like gold, think it's their compassion promise you untold. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count
see what God has done. So amid the conflict, whether great or small, do not be discouraged, God is over all. Count your many blessings, angel will attend. Help and comfort give you to your journey's end. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God has done.
lot of truth in that song, I tell you. That's where true peace lies, the Jesus Christ. I tell you what, I've been looking forward to this. Jamie and me go back, I don't know, 20 years, 25 years. I met Jamie back when I was on the gospel radio. We used to have in Beekman, y'all know where that is? We used to have a quartet convention there at the high school or the school, whatever it was. And I first met Jamie there. And I remember when Jamie had his little baby girl. And I can remember when he came in, 3 foot tall, he was 10 foot tall. And he came in there carrying that little baby girl. And now he's a grandpa, believe it or not. But I tell you, he's going to bless you. And I told him, I said, hey, if you feel like being Pentecostal, let it rip, son. We don't care. We want you to do how the Lord leads you to do. And when I went to Brother Ed, would you come up here? I want you to lay hands on Jamie. And we'll have a word of prayer. And then Jamie will come out here and tell him a little bit about himself. Jamie, what you about it?
Father, indeed a pleasure this morning to have Brother Jamie Coulter with us this morning. We're looking forward to it, and we just pray that you bless him this morning. As he blesses us, we thank you for sending him our way today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Hello, friends. This is Paul Heil from the Gospel Greats radio program. And I want to welcome you to an incredible time of worship with the unique ministry of Jamie Coulter. Jamie was born with a rare disease called osteogenesis imperfecta, which is normally referred to as a brittle bone disease. Jamie has had over 300 broken bones and over 30 major operations. Jamie knows what it means to be broken, but he also knows what it means to see the hand of God do a work in his life. Down through the years, he has traveled worldwide, singing and preaching the gospel, and sharing his testimony of how God has delivered him through the critical times in his life. He has become one of the fastest rising artists in Southern gospel and Christian country music. As Jamie makes his way to the stage, slide to the edge of your seat, get ready for an experience of your life. As he positions himself on his skateboard, grabs his guitar in his hand, and gets behind the microphone to do what God has left him here to do, there is no doubt in my mind that you will never forget this moment in time. So, without further ado, would you put your hands together and make him welcome, all the way from Hamburg, Arkansas, the little giant of gospel music, Mr. Jamie Coulter.
Would you give the Lord a hand clap of praise?
Oh,
thank you. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Appreciate Brother Larry for inviting us here. It's always good to be close to home, amen. And we're from Hamburg, Arkansas. Let me just ask this morning, how many is seeing Jamie Coulter Ministries for the very first time? First timers. Wow. Amen. Well, good to see each one of you here. Let me introduce a young lady sitting up here, all dressed in black today. She's pulling a Johnny Cash on me, I think. But I'm glad to have this young lady here today. She goes just about everywhere I go. Amen. No, I go with her. Amen. She carries me, and it's because she's my wife. I love her with all my heart. Would you make her welcome? Her name's Michelle. She's sitting right down here. Stand up, babe. Yep, stand up. Come on. Amen. And I tell you, I told Brother Larry, we'd just obey the Spirit of the Lord. If I preach, I preach. If I don't, I don't. Amen. We're just going to sing and obey the Spirit of the Lord. Amen. I think that's what we need to do. But I'm going to do a song today that, you know, most of the songs that you might hear me do, the Lord has given to me. But a few of them He hasn't. And this is one that the Lord didn't give to me. I wish He would have. But He gave it to somebody else, somebody that struggled a little bit gospel music. Y'all might have heard of him before, Mr. Rusty Goodman. And Rusty didn't struggle. I was joking about that. The Goodmans became one of the best groups there ever was in gospel music. And long time ago, when I was just a kid, I sang this song. And for some reason, I stopped. But a few years ago, I heard it again. And I thought, you know what? There couldn't be a better place or better time than to start singing that old song again. So we picked it back up. And I hope it touches your heart. You listen to it. Amen. Lately I've got leaving Oh, my, my. I tell you what, before I do this next song, let me do something real quick. Let me ask today, is the sound too loud? Is it too loud? All right. I want it to be comfortable for y'all, and so we're going to pull it down just a little bit, and I can do it up here, buddy. So, if it's still too loud, y'all let me know. We want y'all to be comfortable and be relaxed. Sing that song, Leaving on My Mind. And I don't know about y'all, but it seems that lately I've got leaving on my mind. Man, as you look at this old world and you see the condition of this world and what's going on, as a born-again child of God, you can't help but just say, I'm not a part of it. I'm not from here, amen. One night I was sitting at the house, and I was thinking about a better place. I was thinking about that place that Jesus said, I go to prepare for you. And if I go, I'll come again, and receive you into myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. The Lord gave me a song. I hope it touches your heart. Listen to it. We may need to kick the monitors up just a tad. I read in the Bible long years ago about a man named Jesus who came to save our soul. He left the throne of glory to fulfill a perfect plan. On a hill called Mount Calvary, he gave hope to fallen man. He suffered and he died, but now he lives again. And one day we will see him in that city of no sin. And we will sing hallelujah, say praise to the Lord. We'll lift up holy hands as our spirit starts to soar.
Sing the song together. And we will sing.
what a day, what a glorious day that's going to be when we get over there on the other side. You know, I've had a lot of people ask me a very simple question, but it's hard to answer sometimes. A lot of folks has asked me why I do what I do, and why have I done it so long? Amen. And let me just say something today. It's not for fame, and it's not for fortune. Amen. The reason we do what we do, the reason we've done it for so long. You know, I've been in the ministry for about 43 years. Let me ask something this morning. How many remember I started my ministry right here in Monroe, Louisiana, down at the Civic Center at the United Cerebral Palsy Telethon, singing on it every year? How many remember that? Let me see your hand if you remember that. Some of you do. A lot of folks wonder why we do what we do. And I was sitting at the house one night thinking about that very question. I reached over and picked up a pen and piece of paper and the old guitar. I don't have it here this morning, but anyway, most of the time I'm playing it. But the Lord gave me this song. I hope it touches your heart. before I go on, I tell you what, I was sitting there as I was singing, thinking about this young lady that sang right before me. Did y'all enjoy her? Would you give her a hand? Amen. That song blessed my heart this morning because just a few days ago, we lost one of the greatest in gospel music, Miss Labriska Hemphill. And Joel Hemphill wrote that song, and Candy sang it for many years. And when she sang that song, it touched my heart. And I appreciate you doing that. I sure do. You know, we're not here this morning to entertain you or to put on a show. We're here for one thing, and that's to lift up the name of Jesus. And if you came here for anything else, you came here for the wrong reason. Amen. You know, a lot of people look at me today and they see a little old 3-foot-tall man on a skateboard. And many times they feel sorry for me. Amen. But let me just say something. If you're sitting back there today and you look up here and you see this 3-foot-tall man on a skateboard or in a wheelchair, and you feel sorry for me, let me just say, you're feeling sorry for the wrong one. You need to feel sorry for the one that may be beside you or behind you or in front of you, or maybe yourself, that don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior. You know, I'm glad today that at the age of 13 years old, I gave my life and soul to the Lord. When I was born, the doctors gave me very little hope to live. Said if I'd live, I'd be mentally retarded. But you know what? I thank God that I had a praying mama. A mama that said, God, you gave him the gift of life. If you can give him the gift of life, you can give him the gift of healing. And you know what? A lot of people might think today that God didn't hear her prayer or honor it because I'm the way I am. But you see, you're just not looking at the big picture. What you don't realize is where God's brought me, amen. Man, listen to me. Down through the years, I've had over 300 broken bones and over 30 major operations. From the time that I was born to the time that I was 18, I had over 300 broken bones, over 30 major operations. At the age of 18, I went to the Lord and I said, Lord, here I am. God, you've called me to do a ministry. You've called me to go out and do a work for you. The only thing standing in my way is my physical condition, the breaks. But God, if you want me to go full time, I give it to you. You know what? My next birthday, I'll be 50 years old. You know how many broken bones I've had since then? One. You know why? Some folks might say, well, man, that's a coincidence. No, that's God. And you know what? People today, they look at me and they don't think I can do anything, Brother Larry. They don't think I can feed myself or clothe myself. A lot of folks don't realize I can do just about anything that I want to do. I go hunting. I can do a lot of things y'all can't do, amen. It ain't many of you can go to Walmart, climb under the clothes rack, and when somebody walks by, reach out and grab them, scare them to death. But I can. You say you wouldn't do that, would you? I have before and I will again. Amen. And you know what? We need to realize today that all we've got to worry about is putting our life in the hands of the Lord. Brother Larry told me to obey the the Lord, and I told him I would, and you know, I really wasn't going to plan to preach, but the Lord said in His Word, ye believe in God, believe also in me. He said, let not your hearts be troubled. Think about that. Let not your hearts be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. You say, preacher, how in the world can we live in the society in which we live and not be troubled? The same way I've lived almost 50 years and not worried about a thing. Put our hands, put our lives in the hands of the Lord. Man, don't worry about it. Give it to Him. He has it. Let not your heart be troubled. Don't worry about the things that we can't control. Man, He's got all that taken care of. Just put your life in His hands and let Him have His way. As I said a little earlier, I started years ago. Matter of fact, in about 1972, just right down the road in the Civic Center here in Monroe, a cerebral palsy telethon, and it kind of kicked my ministry off with a song. And this song is what I'm fixing to do now. And today, my friend, if you're sitting here, you don't know the Lord as your personal Savior. You don't have to leave here the same way you came. You can know Jesus as your Lord and Savior. I hope this song blesses your heart.
Will I be a crippled boy up there?
Crippled boy, sit along. Will see watching on the other kids run and play. On his face, I saw you. You know, I feel the presence of the Lord in this place this morning. Most of the time we try to do some upbeat songs, and this morning I've just felt led to just obey the Spirit and do what we've done. And this altar's open all during the service this morning. I'm not going to do but a couple of more songs. But you know, today every one of us is here for a purpose. And whether you realize it or whether you don't, you're going to make a mark in this world with your life. It's going to be a good one or a bad one. And you've got the choice. You've got the control today on your life. You say, no, God's got that control. He don't unless you give it to Him. You've got to give it to Him for Him to have control. And if you haven't today, you need to. Because if you haven't given your life to the Lord, you know what kind of mark you're going to make on your life, with your life, and on a lot of other lives. It ain't going to be good. But when you give your life to Jesus, He makes the difference. I was sitting at the house a few years back. A phone rang. I picked up the phone. Young lady was crying on the other end. Asked me to pray for her. Knowing that she wasn't living for Jesus, I told her I'd pray for her and did on the phone. And I said I'd keep praying for her. Hung up the phone and went in the living room, turned on the TV, sat there and watched it for a few moments. And the Lord spoke to my heart and said, you said you'd pray for that young lady. And I thought, yeah, Lord, I did. Turned the TV off and I went back and I began to pray. Here's what I began to pray. God, you've left me here for a reason. You got a purpose for my life. And as I began to pray, I got to thinking about not only her, but so many hundreds of thousands that were in the same boat that she was in, looking for an answer, looking for hope, looking for peace. And I thought, Lord, if I don't do anything in my life but one thing, everybody I come in contact with, somehow, some way, let me point them to you. And somehow, some way, let me make a difference in their life through you. And the Lord gave me this song. Your love it's getting late, and I'm not going to do but one more song. If y'all just bear with me, just real quickly, I want to do this last song. And I'm sure it's a song that many of y'all have heard before. How many of you remember years ago a TV show that used to come on called the Gospel Singing Jubilee? How many remember that? Many of you? Well, you know, I was just a kid when that show came on, and I can remember as a little boy, every Sunday morning, if I wasn't somewhere out on the road, I was in front of that TV watching the Gospel Singing Jubilee with groups like the Florida Boys, the Kingsmen, the Hemp Hills, and groups like the Hensons. How many of you ever remember the Hensons? If you never heard the Hensons, you missed something. Kenny Henson, I feel, was probably the best singer there ever was or ever will be. And he lost his battle with cancer in 1995. But I can remember sitting watching groups like that, and as a little boy, not realizing in a few years I'd grow up. No, let me rephrase that. I'd get a little older. Amen. And I'd get back out. I'd get out on the road, and I'd share the stage with a lot of them groups. And me and Kenny became best friends. And when Kenny left this walk of life, I lost a friend. And gospel music lost a legend. But for years, I wouldn't do this song because I couldn't do it like Kenny. But a few years ago, I was listening to it, and I thought, you know what? That song still needs to be sang, still needs to be heard. And nobody will ever do it like Kenny Henson. So I decided I'm going to try it. And to my surprise, it became one of our most requested songs. Folks asked us to record it, and so I did. And when I got into Nashville and got into the studio, I called Kenny's nephew, Bo, and I said, "Bo, I'm going in to do a Henson song. Would you come in and help me out?" He said, "Man, I'd love to." And so he did. So for just a moment, let me take you back in time to a certain style and a certain sound as we give tribute to probably one of the best groups there ever was.
It's a light that I might see, and the light that shines in darkness now, someday is gonna safely lead me over. And I know if it wasn't for the lighthouse, I know my ship would sail no more.
Now everybody that lived around us, all around, they say tear the lighthouse down, while they say them old ships, why they don't sail by the sweat, there's no use. You know it was a light from that old lighthouse you love him. Amen. Very quickly, every head bowed, every eye closed. I'm going to ask Brother Larry if he'll come and stand here this morning. And today, I don't know your heart. I don't know your life. But today, if you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, would you do something for me? Would you just bow your head, every head bowed, every eye closed? And if you would, real quickly, just lift up that hand and say, "Preacher, I don't know the Lord. I don't know the Lord. I need Jesus in my life." I'm not going to embarrass you. It's no commitment. But I would today like to pray for you. Is there one in this place? "Preacher, I don't know the Lord. I don't know him." God bless that hand. I see it. Is there another one? "Preacher, I just don't know the Lord. I need Jesus in my life." Is there one more? Is there one more? Come on. Every head bowed, every eye closed. No one looking around. Except for those that raised your hand. If you raised your hand, would you look up here at me just for a moment? You can be saved today. God wants to save you. He allowed you to be in this place, this very moment, for this very reason. This brother standing here, he can't save you, but he can lead you to a Savior. I want you to do something. If you raise your hand right now, would you just come and take this brother by the hand and say, "I need the Lord. I need Jesus. I don't want to die and go to hell. I need the Lord in my life." Would you come right now? Right now? Would you come? If you raise your hand, just step on out. Real quickly. Real quickly, would you come?
I would be.
Come on.
Without him, I could be dying.
I'd be dying. Father, in Jesus'
without
name.
Him,
Lord, you saw the hands. You know the needs. God, I just ask you right now that, Lord, you'll move. God, I pray that you'll minister. God, each one, they've raised their hands, said, "I need Jesus in my life and in my heart." God, let them invite you in. Let them feel that peace that passes all understanding. God, we love you today. Thank you for loving us. God, you just move. Minister in Jesus'
name.
Maybe today you might be saved. But you want to just come, get on your knees. This is a new year. You might want to just come to this altar and say, "God, help me this year. Be the Christian I need to be. Be the servant that I need to be." If you would you just step out and come to this altar? You say, "Preacher, it's late." It's not too late for you to do what God wants you to do. Would you let him have his way? You know when it's going to be too late? When you draw your last breath and you've not done what God wants you to do. That's when it's going to be too late, my friend. That's when it's going to be late. Can you think about that? Would you let him have his way right now? Without him, you have nothing.
Oh,
but with him, you've got it all. Do you know him today? Do you know him today? Don't turn him away.
Jesus. I would be.
Let's sing that chorus again.
With Jesus, oh Jesus, do you know him today? Please don't turn him away. Oh Jesus, oh Jesus, without him, how lost I would be.
Just we're not going to close. God's still moving. Still moving. Still working today. Oh, thank you, Lord. Christians, we need to pray. You know what? Man, we need to pray today that more churches in America will go over 12 o'clock. Come on. You think I'm joking? No, I'm serious, honey. Man, they need to obey the Spirit of the Lord. Say, Lord, we're not worried about the time. We want you to come in and settle down. We want you to have your way in our life, in our church. We want you to move. It's not about time. Life's as a vapor, it appears for a little while and it vanishes away. But without him, we have nothing. About you, I'm glad I have it.
Without him, I'd be the same. Without him, I would be drifting like a ship without a sail.
Sing it.
Jesus, oh Jesus, do you know him today? Please don't turn him away. Oh Jesus, oh Jesus, without him, how lost I would be.
Have you enjoyed being in the house of the Lord?
Amen.
Would you give him a hand clap of praise? Do you love him, church? He's worthy, worthy to be praised. Amen. Thank you for coming. Let me just say a few things. I do appreciate you having us here. Y'all pray for us as we go on our journey up and down the highways and the byways, doing what God has called us to do. And I have some dear friends that came all the way from way down past Alexandria, Louisiana. I'm glad they got to come. They're sitting here on the third row here. And the Teal family, I want y'all to make them welcome. They came this morning. And a good friend of mine, Rod Teal, Stoney's dad, went on to be with the Lord a few weeks ago. I miss him here. I know he'd be here. Brandy. Brandy was his wife. But you know what? There's a better place on the other side. Thank y'all for coming today. I want to say that we have some things available in the back if you're interested. My wife will be back there. Thank you. God bless you. Have you enjoyed being in the house of the Lord? Amen.
Did y'all get blessed? I tell you,
If he didn't set you on fire this morning, I'll tell you, your old kindling's wet, you know that. Appreciate you, Jamie. Love you. He's going to be here tonight. And he's going to bless you tonight. And don't forget, he come here on a love offering. And this goes to help spread his ministry. And it's not cheap going on that road. And he's doing it for the Lord. And he's saving a lot of souls while he's doing this. Brother Mike, I'm going to turn it over to you.
Just give you a report. Kelly Harbor came this morning accepting the Lord Jesus as her Lord and Savior and wants to be a member here, be a part of Ouachita Baptist Church. So I'm not sure what all the process is. Me being here, do y'all vote to receive her today? Everybody in favor of receiving her, say amen. I know you are. Those opposed, like sign. Thank you for that decision this morning.
All righty. Y'all bring your tithes up here. And I'm sure it's going to bless a lot of people out there to hear this little guy. I'd like to thank you all for coming out this morning. You're all dismissed. Come back this evening. Jamie's going to bless us some more. Good singing, preaching, I hope.